Marvel fans, thanks so much for clicking on this video. My name is Chris. We finally got here a damn Marvel trailer to gaze at. That is the trailer for Shang-Chi. The first one has been released online. I have been dying to see this movie. It's the one I'm actually most looking forward to out of the new lineup of heroes in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And I could say you definitely could call this one a teaser because it left me wanting a little bit more. But nonetheless, what I'm going to do here for you guys is giving you my trailer breakdown for Shang-Chi, pointing out Easter eggs you might have missed, explaining the world and some of the characters we have in here. But I'm gonna need you guys to leave me your opinions down below. What did you think of the Shang-Chi trailer? Did this trailer hype you up to see this new Marvel superhero come into the MCU? Did the trailer leave you wanting more and maybe a little disappointed? Be honest, go ahead and leave your thoughts right down below. So the trailer opens up here with Simu Liu, who is playing the titular character Shang-Chi. I gotta say, I am a fan of this actor. I started watching him in the show Kim's Convenience, and I find him to be pretty charming and funny, so I think he was a great addition for the Marvel Cinematic Universe and to play the character of Shang-Chi. Now, when talking about the character of Shang-Chi from the comic books, he doesn't have any superpowers per se. He's just a man who's really in tune with his body's chi and has mastered the art of Kung Fu to where he's the best hand-to-hand combat fighter in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. In the most recent adaptations of the comics, they have given him the ability to split his body and fight that way, but it's unclear if Marvel is also going to give him that ability. But here we open up on a place where he was trained as a child in the Ten Rings organization. This is an organization that has also been a part of the MCU since the very beginning in the first Iron Man, the terrorist group organization that some Marvel fans felt wasn't really done to justice. Kind of the whole point of Shang-Chi is to bring those characters to justice, but we'll get to more on that in a sec. Here, it's just the spot where he was being trained at as a child. The voiceover that we get to see in this trailer is actually from Shang-Chi's father. We do cut away from that though, and we get to see Shang-Chi's current life right now in America, living in California, where he fled the Ten Rings organization, his training, his lifestyle, all because he just wanted a normal life and didn't like the way he was being raised to be this ultimate warrior. Here's where we'll see him work just a regular day job of him being a valet attendant, where he meets his best friend, played by Awkwafina, named Katie. Now we get to see the two interact a lot in this trailer. This is just the friendship that they've built up. I find Awkwafina to be pretty funny, so I'm glad she's being added on here to the cast as the dorky best friend. Moving on to the next couple shots of the trailer, this is where we get introduced to some of the deeper characters in the Shang-Chi lore. We have here young Shang-Chi training in front of this board where he was just pounding away as part of strengthening his fists and muscles. We have here to the left, Wen Wu, his father. At this time, he's currently the leader of the Ten Rings organization and building up this army of fighters, while right next to him is one of the most ferocious warriors in the Ten Rings organization, a Death Dealer. Now, this Death Dealer is actually a character from the comic books and is one of the most formidable foes of Shang-Chi. It's one of the warriors that they'll keep around to keep these kids in line and make sure that they are going with their training and also sparring with them while holding no mercy. You can definitely understand why Shang-Chi went ahead and fled this organization to live a better life on his own in California, because this obviously left a lot of trauma with him and did not like the way he was being treated. Continuing on with more flashbacks of Shang-Chi's past, I'm sure this is how they're going to tell the origin story. We'll get a non-linear movie where we have current events and then flashbacks to things that he did as a child that he remembers a lot. But one key moment here to look at is how the Marvel Cinematic Universe is going to be bringing to life the Ten Rings from the comics, because one of the reasons this organization is called the Ten Rings is because of the Ten Rings of Power, something that people have always wanted to see in the MCU, especially when the fake Mandarin in Iron Man 3 teased wearing 10 rings on his fingers, only for those not to mean anything. In the MCU, the 10 rings will be rings, but they'll be more like bracelets instead of actual rings on your fingers. We have here Wen Wu's character wearing those 10 rings on each one of his hands. And in the comics, each ring is actually supposed to signify a certain power that the user is able to get with them. On the left hand, you have here Pinky, Ice Blast, freezes the air in its path and can lower an object's temperature to almost absolute zero. Ring Finger, Mental Intensifier, magnifies the physique energy, enabling him to mentally control a person, only effective at a short range. Middle Finger, Electro Blast, emits quantities of electric energy determined by the wearer. Upper limit of output is unknown. Index Finger is Flame Blast, emits infrared radiation and can also cause air incandesce by igniting its molecules. Thumb, white light. Emanates many different types of energy from the electromagnetic spectrum frequently used to intense visible light and laser beams. Right hand, you have pinky. Black light creates area of absolute blackness where all light is absorbed. It is believed that the rings access the dark force. Disintegration beam destroys bonds between atoms and molecules, causing the object's cohesion to fall apart. Vortex beam causes air to swirl about in a vortex at high speed, can levitate objects, propel water in flight, and be used as a weapon. Index finger impact beam projects concussion force of approximately 350 pounds of TNT, can also cause intense sonic vibrations and create magnetic waves. Thumb matter rearranger can rearrange atoms and molecules of substance or speed up, slow down their movements to result in various effects. Cannot actually transmute elements. It's unclear if Marvel is going to take those exact same powers and throw them each one into the 10 rings or just make the user himself very powerful, but they definitely emanate some sort of energy, because in the next shot here we see his father using it with some energy projectile coming off of it. More shots of Shang-Chi training as a teenager and even being able to take down a room of warriors, cutting back and forth to his present day life. Further shots include that Shang-Chi seems to be part of some cage match fighting, so this could be an underground way that he earns more money, because I'm sure valet parking isn't really paying the rent all that well. And the one thing he's truly skilled at is beating down some people. It's also worth noting that in the background of this cage fighting area, we have a Captain America shield. We've heard that in Spider-Man No Way Home, there's also gonna be some Captain America posters out and about, and there's even gonna be a shield set to be on the Statue of Liberty. So kind of interesting that you see a Captain America shield here in the background to where Shang-Chi is fighting. This is also where we get a hint to another villain in the Shang-Chi world. This character is named Douglas Scott, or Razor Fist. In the comics, he's said to be a brilliant martial artist turned mercenary who has a hand replaced with a sword. Further on in the trailer, we get to see him actually use this extended hand as a sword that even seems to light up and have some sort of heating effect attached to it. From there, it looks like Shang-Chi is willing to listen to his father and come back to the Ten Ring organization, at least to hear him out, because it looks like something has gone wrong with it. In the back, you can see here Wenwu, his father, Razor Fist, and the character of Yi Ling. Hopefully I pronounced that right, but this will actually be Shang-Chi's sister in the movie. So you can definitely bet there's going to be a dynamic here, but it's also said that Shang-Chi is unaware that he had a sister, and this will be the first time she shows up in his life. Giving us our first look here of the MCU's version of the Mandarin. No fake Mandarin. This guy is the real deal, sitting in his throne in front of a wall with the 10 rings and also wearing the 10 rings himself. Marvel heard the outcry of fans of how the Mandarin was treated in Iron Man 3, that they finally wanted to bring him forward. Some things that we know about him is that he's not happy that there was a fake Mandarin out in the world. He's also way more harsh with the organization and is the reason it's more of a terrorist group instead of what it originally seemed to be, which is a protector of China. And thanks to some toy leaks that we've gotten for Shang-Chi, it looks like the significance to collect all the 10 rings is to bring together this mythical dragon that they're calling the Great Protector. Here you have a Funko Pop of it. Of course I would know about it because of this Funko Pop. Cutting the shot to someone actually using the 10 rings and about to face off against an entire army here, even with giant animals in the back. I feel like this is going to be a flashback and an explanation to where the 10 rings come from and how long they have been embedded in the history of China and the 10 rings organization, because we do get a hint of that in other parts of this trailer. To me, what I really wanted to see the most out of everything in here though was some kung fu fighting, and we do get a taste of that here with Shang-Chi going off against this death dealer. There's definitely some resentment there of how this guy abused him as a child and forcing him and whipping him to hit this board over and over. We get a shot here also of Wenwu fighting off against Jiang Li. Now, not much is known about her character here. I would not be surprised if she turns out being the mother of Shang-Chi, and this sequence might be a flashback to how they met and eventually fell in love to have their children. A shot here that involves the cage match of Shang-Chi fighting his newly discovered sister. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a bit of a Thor and Loki situation going on here, where she just really resents her brother because he's destined to be the ultimate warrior and the best fighter of the Ten Rings organization when she went through the exact same training and did not flee the organization to go to California. From there, it's just more action-packed shots with a little Marvel goofing around. One random Marvel Easter egg that you could find here is that this character right here, or this background actor, has actually already appeared in a Spider-Man movie, Spider-Man Homecoming. This was the guy who told Spider-Man to do a flip. Pretty funny that he moved his hot dog station, I guess, from New York all the way to California, but it's just one of the things that connects all the Marvel Cinematic Universe movies. Don't think there'll really be a big significance to his character. He just might have been an extra who showed up on this Marvel set without them even knowing it was the same same guy. They did release some photos online of what he'll be looking like in his full-fledged costume. I guess I'm okay with it. We can't expect much. The guy has to be doing martial arts in this, and he's not really a superhero. He's just a man is really in tune with his body's chi and is the best martial artist on earth. But I'm gonna be checking out this movie either way. What did you guys think about the trailer for Shang-Chi? Are there any Easter eggs in there that you caught that I might have missed? Will you be watching this movie, or do you need to see maybe another trailer to hype you up for this thing? Anything and everything, be sure to like and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter at 3C Film Review. As always, I'm Chris. Take care.